13 Folds. Its views and opinions are meant for entertainment purposes only and should be taken at face value after carefully researching the discussed topics. Any discussions that actually contain legitimate news should be viewed as nothing more than pure chance and or coincidence. Most facts and statistics are neither confirmed nor denied unless stated otherwise, and should never be used as irrefutable evidence. All celebrity and in or non-infamous guests are mere subpar impersonations of those implied by the context and frame in which said celebrities are represented. In no means has any said celebrity or person ever associated or implied association with 13 Folds Radio. Please direct any questions, concerns, complaints to the contact form at 13foldradio.com.
Friends, you're listening to 13 Folds Radio, and if you recognize this voice, You must not be a new listener. This is Mike Liberty coming at you from our secret studios here in Providence, Rhode Island. As always, with my main man, Dave Death.
Hey, hey, hey.
There he is. How you doing tonight, David?
Doing good, man.
Nice. You want me to bring in the special guest now?
Oh, yeah. Let's introduce
him. We are sitting down with one hell of a man, a genius, a scholar, a world changer, Mr. Suarez Alexander. How you doing tonight, Suarez?
How you doing out there, people? I just like to dedicate this show to Gracelyn Beatty. She's on her way out. May you pass in peace and arise in Israelite.
Amen.
How you people doing?
Good, good.
Yeah, we're chilling, man. Glad you come out with us. Thanks for hanging with us.
I've been waiting to do this show for a long time, actually. I've been trying to get Suarez to come on the show for probably a year now. And so finally being able to get him out here, it's a big deal to me. I look at him like the conspiracy theorist of religion. You know, like when I hear the stuff that Suarez drops sometimes, man, it's like it'll make you think. It's out there, but it makes you think. It makes you ask questions, and that's what we're all about, you know?
I'll tell you what, man. I wouldn't limit it to religion. So we've been hanging with Suarez for, I don't know, 2-3 hours at this point before sitting down to do this show. And good God, brother, we covered everything. Religion, race, history, UFOs, geology, geography.
If you're going to do the knowledge, then, you know, sit down. You can't participate.
And, man, did we wind a crazy path. I don't want to get too much into it.
We got plenty of time.
Yeah, we do.
We got weeks to get into it now, I think.
I'll give you the tip of the iceberg. We're going to dive sideways into race relations this evening.
Yes, we are.
And like I said, I think that's just the tip of the... We might only spend a few seconds on that, and we're just going to see where it goes. But I don't know. Before we get into even any of that, what do you got, man?
Honestly, today's the day that the judge in New York dropped the verdict for the Brady deflate gates.
That would be Judge Berman?
Judge Berman. I don't know. I don't pay too much attention to names.
Judge names.
To judge names. I'm usually looking at the ground when I'm standing in front of a judge.
You had me at Judge Dredd.
So they made the announcement that Brady is going to play. He won. They dismissed all the charges.
I mean,
Brady
won. Everything. Complete Brady win. Won. This is like O.J. Simpson all over again.
Whoa.
Well, let's hope not. Let's hope nobody died over the football game.
Well, you never know. Some dudes in Vegas.
Yeah, there might be a ball handle missing somewhere.
Yeah.
But, just talk about an absolute faceplant for the NFL.
Well, and that's it. I think the next step you're looking at is what's going to happen to Roger Goodell. We talked about that last year with everything with Ray Rice and Adrian Peterson.
And that was exactly the point I wanted to make, and I agree. I think he's got to be on his way out at this point because you're talking literally 1 year ago, and he's stepping into it, just fucking it up with Ray Rice, likewise with Adrian Peterson, and now here he is 1 year later. And he just, I mean, they got killed
well,
today.
And then there's all the other players who have been, and great players, Josh Gordon from Cleveland, Cecil Shorts last year for Jaguars. I hate to add great player and Jacksonville Jaguars together, but.
But you got to bring up them
Jags. For marijuana and cannabis. Mm-hmm. You hear nothing about that. And we've been going at this for, 7 months?
Yes, exactly.
About deflated balls.
An equipment violation, really.
This has gotten more traction than Adrian Peterson's daycare service. Ray Rice's certified marriage counselor. You know, it's gotten more coverage than all of it. Nobody's talking about any of that. And he tried to dish out a worse punishment for deflated balls, which when you really look at it, the responsibility falls back on the NFL.
On
it's
the
their
league.
Refs.
On the league, exactly.
That allowed that to happen. It was their foresight.
And that's just it.
Hindsight,
so every step that he's taken now on every issue that's come up has been in the wrong direction consistently.
I'm glad Brady won. I felt like they never had actual proof. I'm not certain that he didn't know anything about it or whatever, but there is no proof.
Well, can I put my Mike Liberty hat on for a minute?
You
I'm
can.
Glad that this thing is quote unquote over because it's bad enough. The realm of billionaires and millionaires squabbling pisses me off. When it starts to cost me as a taxpayer for them to settle their stupid little squabbles as it did in a federal court and would and will if and when it climbs the court system to the Supreme Court, to me, That's bullshit. That's when I start to turn my back and say enough is enough. You guys, you go shoot marbles off on your own. Don't include me in that.
Yeah.
Yeah, I totally agree with that. So it should be someone who's not really into the sport. The fact that my tax dollars are going towards something that I don't even use or do in my personal time is very upsetting, I think.
Well, and a lot of these stadiums are built with tax dollars.
Exactly. Yeah. And that's the kind of stuff that turns me off from professional sports.
Well, it really adds to the, I mean, we're struggling as a middle class and lower class trying to make ends meet. And they keep hiking up taxes and hiking, you know, it's tougher every day, yet we're rejoicing over a new stadium, you know. In Rhode Island, they're going at it about trying to put a stadium in Providence.
Yeah.
You know, and
yep. For a minor league baseball team.
Yeah, for a minor league baseball team, and it's going to come out of our pockets.
Right. When John Henry's got more money than Solomon, and this is his investment. What am I? Am I ever going to get a return?
No.
You know, you talk about Rhode Island taxpayers. How about the whole Studio 38 thing with Curt Schilling?
Yeah, they dropped the ball.
You know,
on that.
All that money, and now again, you know, you've got to get a federal judge involved, ordering the state to turn over all their documents, and we're talking more tax dollars. We're talking more foolish insider backroom deals. When does it end? When do we collectively say enough is enough?
Well, because we're distracted, and that's the problem, is they have us distracted by the shit they're showing us on YouTube and on TV. And
professional
on the news
baseball
all the
players
time.
Selling video games. I mean, there you go, right there. If that's a double whammy of distraction.
So, we can talk about that all next week. I have a funny feeling we're not going to have time to talk about anything else.
No, I think that's tonight. That. Yeah, let's.
You know, but. Before we even get started, you know, we're going to play some music. I actually have a new song. It's one of Jack White's projects coming out. The Dead Weather is the name of the band. Album is Dodge and Burn, and the song is called I Feel Love. We're going to play that for you. But before we do that, I want to thank our sponsors, who without you guys would not be able to do this. Canacare. There are some things marijuana can't fix, but for everything else, there's Canacare. Northeast Organic Solutions, the organic alternative to all of your extraction needs. Greenside Up, fine purveyors of glass, art, and elegant pieces. Merchant's Bank Card Systems, making electronic transactions easy since 1989. And, of course, Circle Jerk Productions. We make sound happen. Sometimes.
That's a really great tagline, by the way.
I told you I was going to do a different one each week. So I gotta work up some. We're going to have to take some time and come up with a bunch of different taglines for Circle Jam Productions.
But in the meantime, turn up your speakers, because here comes a little bit of music. Don't go anywhere. We got a hell of a lot of ground to cover tonight here on 13 Folds Radio on
rifreeradio.org.
Black top, know that I have not cracked with my mind.